Hi and welcome back to another video of JPlay. I am Marcus and today I'm starting my solo playthrough of Embarcadero. I read the rules and originally I really thought it would be a good idea giving this solo mode a try here. Then I played it with four players and I really liked it. It was a tad too long for my taste, at least for what it is, but it was still fun, but very thinky game. But this really made me question my original decision going with a solo playthrough of this. And after a lot of back and forth, actually, I decided, okay, let's give it a try, but let's see about that. So I'm a little bit curious at least, and yeah, let's see how things go. I'm pretty sure I will not be able to score a hell of a lot of points, but I think I come to the end of game conditions in a second once I set up the game board here. But yeah, let's see how things go, huh? Shall we? Okay, and here we are. That's the setup for the solo mode. You have a lot of options with the unsinkable expansion, and honestly, I only shuffled in the extra cards, so I'm not playing with the event cards, for example. Yeah, it's basically only the event cards, I believe, that I'm kind of missing out, because I'm definitely using the unsinkable ships and the entrepreneur buildings. Yeah, so basically 2 out of 3, that's not bad. The only thing I'm missing out are those event cards, because I really think things are already quite complicated as they are. So down here, I already prepared the game board in respect to the sole proprietor. That's the AI player. I think there is some kind of an AI. The AI doesn't score any points. It's only here to annoy me, kind of. So when it comes down to whatever, scoring those wharfs, for example, that's when the sole proprietor comes into the picture, pretty much make the board a little bit more crowded. Because really playing this on your own would be very, very boring and maybe something worth considering taking more than one sole proprietor into the mix. I don't know. Because again, I think the more the merrier. So the sole proprietor starts with these level 6 ships here down here. I think you kind of are free to choose where they are placed on which side of the wharfs here. You start the game as per default rules with a 3-size ship and 3 structures on them. So in theory, you could start building a size 3 building right off the get-go. Because I decided to play as Levi Strauss and not using the advanced side here, I get to start on 7 victory points. Hooray! And yeah, Strauss came to San Francisco to open a branch of his family's dry goods business. He made his fortune selling his riveted denim work pants. And again, on the other side, they all come with special abilities. Again, we are not playing with those here today. And yeah, his starting bonus, which is the same for both sides, we always have 1 piece of wood, which I believe doesn't really help me right away. Yeah, let's see about that. And yeah, I already have drafted my starting hand of cards. The way how this works is you get 4 buildings, you get 4 ships, and then you have to discard down to 5. The problem with this is you still have to pay for the cards you keep. So in this case, I already lost $5. You start the game with 15, and money can be incredibly tight in this game. And yeah, in respect to the starting offering, that's what we have. We have 4 ships, we have 4 buildings. You get a card basically each round. You have to buy a card each round. The same is somewhat true to the sole proprietor, who takes then also a card from the opposite selection. So let's say I take the roan here, then the sole proprietor, I would go for the tax office, and the other way around. If I would go for the theater, the sole proprietor would go for the superior and then would place them onto the map where we do see fit. One, I think, major change in the solo mode is that we are not using those round scoring cards, or I'm not sure what those are referred to. Let me quickly check the rules. I suck. I know. No, gold cards. Pretty simple. So we are not playing with those. So the only real scoring we do is in respect to the city council track. So the depending on where we make it at the end of, let's say, round 2 and round 3, we will score that. And we will also score all those wharf tiles here accordingly. not tiles, all the wharfs here accordingly, basically starting from top down to bottom, pretty much counting the majority. And also, unlike the multiplayer game, you either win or you tie, then you get the full amount of victory points. If you have fewer structures closer to those wharfs, again, I will go into more detail there, you will not get anything. Typically, the second player would get half of it. The name of the game in the solo game is to score as many points as possible. So it's kind of a beat your own score, but at least there is some table here which tells you what you need to achieve. I typically don't like these kind of beat your own kind of scoring games, but I think that's okay because, yeah, I have some tables. So I guess I definitely want to do better than the lemonade stand here, for example. So cash cow, I would be already pretty happy. The cool thing about this is, though, there are also optional achievements which you of course have to, I don't know, agree with yourself upon if you want to do that or not. So for example, we could say we could set ourselves a target and say we want to at least achieve the cash cow in respect to points, but we also want to become the mayor, which means we want to reach the end of the council track, which is not easy, let me assure you this. So here I'm really not sure if that's realistic or not. So I think from my multiplayer experience, yes, it's doable getting those points and also reaching the track of the end, but to me it sounds more interesting. So let's agree on this. So we want to be the mayor and we want to have at least the cash cow level here at the end of the game. You never got rich, but you made a living, not bad, okay? But with being a mayor, that's still good enough, I would think. And yeah, I think with that being said, we should be able to start playing finally. We will always be the starting player and we have exactly three actions to choose from during our action phase. We can dock a ship, we construct a building, or we can scrap a card. After we have done that action, we come to the buy phase where we have to play a card and then we have to park a card for the next round. That's really a very clever mechanic in this game. It makes the game extremely thinky, really extremely thinky. But also, I think there are really some tough decisions that you have to take here. And by the way, we are playing this game over three rounds. Each round consists of exactly five, let's say, turns or action phases, because we have five cards. So we will basically using all our cards with some caveats here, because we could still park some of our cards here for the next round. But I think I will come to that too. So let's look at our hand of cards again. And yeah, we have some or three buildings here. Again, I made the choice here. So I had eight cards to choose from. So I can blame no one else but myself with the, let's say, at least this short list of cards here. Of course, those cards have been given to me randomly. And I think this is not really sure it's problematic, but yeah, depending on what you get, yeah, I think it's at least dictating your initial moves to some extent, or maybe even the midterm strategy. So I have some good ships here. I also have some buildings here. So the monument is something I could build right away, because the building requirements here for those buildings are here on the right-hand side of that card. I start the game as Levi Strauss, so I always start with some wood. So in theory, I could go for this monument here, which would give me some income and also would give me a target for the end of the game, because for every paper I have, so basically a symbol or on tokens later on, I would score two extra points and get 1 point right off the bat. And I think because I don't really have a three building right now, that might not be the worst thing to do, actually. So yeah, let's do that. So we park our little monument over here. Again, these are the building requirements. We have the wood from Levi Strauss. Awesome. On the left-hand side, we have, let's say, the ongoing bonus. If there is any, in this case, the monument gives us an income of 1 at the end of each round. So in this case, that's 3 money. And again, money can be incredibly tight. And here we have some values. What would happen if you would scrap a card? That's really a very cool card to scrap. 5 money, all placing 3 structures is huge. Then we will already or immediately score the 1 point. Again, we started at 7 because we chose the basic side of our character, so we are already at 8 out of our 75 minimum, not too bad. And last but not least, of course, we have to build the building in the end. And apparently during the gold rush in San Francisco, where this is all taking place here, people started to build buildings on top of ships, and that's what we are doing here. So we started with one foundation here, and you have to start placing your buildings onto existing foundations. So you cannot directly place a building directly here onto the water. Doesn't help us or doesn't work. The same is true for the wharf. We cannot build over the wharf, which is why we have to build this stuff onto our ships here, and we always have to place it, or we have to have a level of structures, let's say between the ship and the building we are building here. So in this case, the only thing we could place this building, and this was a size 2 building, and that's something that you can tell from these dots here, but also from this number. So that's a size 2 building. So I guess we are placing this building right here. And a building is pretty much only this tile here. So not the structures, this is the building. A little bit counterintuitive to some extent, but yeah, when you start playing, it starts making sense. So this was the building. As a bonus for placing a standard building, we always are allowed to place one structure onto the newly set building here in this case. There are later on ways to extend those structures, but also to whatever, fill a building completely when you are reaching specific conditions here in this case. But that's pretty much already it in respect to our building action or constructing action. So next we come to the buy phase. So we buy a card and then we have to choose a card from our hand to store it. And again, we are storing it here for the next round, not for the next turn, for the next round. So this will be the starting hand of cards once we have built our way here through the first round. Okay, yeah, let's look at the cards again. And yeah, this ship costs 2, this ship costs 3, this 0, this is 1. So that's pretty much the most important information that we have to look at right now. We have 10 bucks still left, which is okay, but the money will be gone. So we are not able to build any more buildings with the current structures we have. So we either get something to whatever, get ourselves more structures out there. So looking at those scrap symbols here, for example, the theater is pretty amazing actually, because it allows you for its scrap action to play three structures onto your existing ships or onto buildings that you have started, and also you get to buy the next card you're paying for or buying for free, so you could save up to 3 bucks, and that's typically huge in this game. So again, what are we interested in? And quite honestly, I'm looking at the Rhone here because it comes with some stone, and right now we don't have any buildings that would give us stone, so I guess that's the one we are going with. So we are taking this into our hand. Before we replenish, the sole proprietor will take their turn. So that's also something that you have to consider in this case. So what are you doing in respect to which card you are taking? How could this affect the decisions, quote unquote, for the sole proprietor? But let's first add this card to our hand, and then we have to make a choice which card to park for the next round. So the police station is awfully expensive, as you can see, in respect to resources. It requires us to sink a ship, we have to spend 2 bucks, and we have to have all of those resources here. So maybe that's something we want to park for the next round. It's a cool card, it gives us income, and if we would scrap it, we would gain some additional wharf tiles or infill tiles, for example. But I still think that this is something we could look for in the next round. So we want to prepare for a level 4 building here. So we are taking this card and placing this onto our player board here accordingly. So we know that this card will be one of the 5 cards we are going to use for our next round. Again, I'm by far not an expert in this game. I didn't really play particularly well in our multiplayer game. Again, I liked it. I think I was chasing the wrong strategies. So I'm pretty sure something similar will happen here too. But again, it's a very, very enjoyable game. And here I'm not 100% sure if the sole proprietor should take that turn before I'm choosing a car to park or not. I don't think it does matter too much, because in theory I have all the information. So yeah, but in this case the sole proprietor will go for the opposite card here of the card I have chosen. So when I'm choosing a ship, again, the sole proprietor will always go with the building, and vice versa. So in this case We are going with a tax office.
It is a size 4 building here accordingly, and there are some rules which are kind of clearly outlined on this solo player 8 here on this little card, but there is also relatively good set of instructions in the rules. I think I understood it, so in theory you want to close it as close as possible to the shore and also as close as possible to any wharf tiles. Again, in this case, I really am tight, or the is tight, so I can choose any wharf here. And I think in this case, does it matter too much? Do I want to keep it close to me or not? Maybe I do. Again, we only have two structures here, but the sole proprietor always gets to place them in case of a need. And again, we are placing it as close as possible to the... Oh, that's an interesting one. Is that a game breaker? As close to the active wharf as possible, on the lowest level possible, as close to the shore as possible. So in this case, I think the tiebreaker here is definitely the wharf, and then only then would we be able to place it here. And that works for the sole proprietor. In this case, you want to have these structures as close to the wharf as possible. This structure here is not directly adjacent to the wharf, so it will not count in respect to any majorities. Only structures that are really directly adjacent to a wharf tile are affected accordingly. So then this, again, this was a level 4 building, so we have to place the building here. All right. And then again, we also only get one structure, so similar to what we are doing. And again, we have to look at the... Oh no, we didn't get to choose actually. Oh, that was stupid for me. In this case, we are looking where this token is, of course. So that's, sorry, silly me, but I played it correctly. This is where we have the saw for. This will move down, then down, and this will tell us, okay, this is the wharf that the sole proprietor is interested in. But in this case, again, we are placing a structure as close as possible to the wharf, as close as possible to the shore. And I think in this case, this totally makes sense. So he built the tax office here. The tax office is discarded from the game for good. So we are, again, I doesn't score any points whatsoever. And then last thing to do is to refill here. So we have the Elmira. Okay, that's a good ship. And another monument. Interesting. That's really interesting. And these symbols here are usually very interesting if you are playing with this goal cards, which you always do in a multiplayer game. In a solo game, I don't really think that these matter too much. But yeah, there are some immediate bonuses that you get depending that, let's say, if this one here, for example, this gives you 3 points for each blue building that you have in your blue symbol that you have in your display at the end. So it still counts, but not for any majorities at the end of, let's say, a given round. One thing I nearly forgot, we are moving the score marker down to the next wharf. So now we know that this wharf is what the sole proprietor is interested in. Right now we are winning this one with 4 structures, and we count them from each level in this case, versus only one structure from the AI player. So in this case, we really want to make sure, for example, that we are not giving the AI player too many structures here, because then we would maybe only tie, or maybe the sole proprietor would even outsmart us here. And right now these are 7 points at the end of this round, and also 7 points at least at the end of the third round. So yeah, something worth considering now. But now it's our turn. So again, we have the choice of docking a ship, construct a building, or scrap a card. I think we want to, yeah, we have to start building more foundations, I believe. What scrap things do we have? This would give us this, this would give us this. I think doing this now could be our best bet. So yeah, I think we are docking the treaty, because we also want the clay here that this comes with. So this is a size 4 ship actually, which we can in theory place nearly everywhere, but of course it still has to connect to something existing. So this could be another ship, this could be a wharf, it could be an infill, or maybe a wharf tile. So we could not place this ship in here, that's not allowed. But in theory we could place it here, because it's touching a wharf. And the main rule here is, the more orthogonal edges you are placing next to wharf, the more you have to pay, and that's 1 for 1. So in this case, 1 edge is adjacent to a wharf, you would pay 1 coin, 2 coins, 3 coins, 4 points. Coins, you get the idea. Because I set myself a very tough goal to move up the city council, I think I have to start building closer to the sole proprietor. So I think I will place this ship in here. This is not touching the wharf, which means it's totally free of charge in this case. Again, only if it's touching the dark brownish thing here. Similar to a building, we could play, or we are allowed to place one of our structures onto the newly placed ship, and we want to place that structure next to the structure of the sole proprietor. Because it's the same level in this case, we are getting one step on the city council track. And yes, it really takes a hell of a lot of effort moving it down. Right now we are not getting any bonuses, but this will change basically depending on how far we are moving. Here we get one of these advanced resources, he would get a landmark card, he would be allowed to place one additional structures, he would score 3 points at the end of the game, for example, things like that. And again, we want to make it to the end of this track, which would then also give us 20 points at the end of the game, and that's definitely something. The ship goes into our display here, and all of those resources will give us the resources pretty much until the end of the game, unless we are sinking a ship, for example. So this ship will always now provide us with 2 clay whenever we need to build something. We never have to spend those, at least not those basic resources here. So we have those at our disposal. And yeah, having 2 clays is definitely not a bad thing. Next, we have to build a car. So that was our action phase already. And here I'm really thinking about, yeah, getting the theater here just for the scrap ability. It only costs us $1, and if we would scrap it, we would gain, yeah, I think that's what we want to do. We need to be able to place those structures here. This is a building from the expansion, by the way. They typically don't come with any specific bonuses here, but they count for 2 symbols. That's huge. And yeah, we have ships, so I think, yeah, we want to go with the theater in this case, which would mean the sole proprietor would go for the superior, a level 4 ship, but yeah, I think that's okay, I guess. So yeah, let's go for the theater. So we are spending $1 here. Again, this goes to our hand. We get to choose which card we are going to park now. And those are really some tough decisions. And I guess we want to have a ship at least next round. So is it this gives us an income, so maybe we want to still place this ship for the income. Yeah, let's place the Rhone. I think we don't need, no, I don't think we need the stone this round, at least I think. So yeah, let's place it down here accordingly. And then it's the sole proprietor's turn. Again, he will go for the superior. It's a level 4 ship. We are dealing with this wharf here. And again, we want to place the ship as close to the wharf, as close to the shore. Yes. So we are placing it pretty much like this. I also get 1 structure, which means right now he's at only 2 here, which is okay. We are at 4, so we might be able to score these 7 points at the end of the game, end of the round, and we desperately need it for sure. And that's already the end of the iPlayer's turn. So placing those ships is relatively simple. Again, next time I would start extending the wharf here. In this case, this would even work for us. So in this case, if we could do it, we would do it just to maximize our points, because again, for every wharf tile we have, we will score additional points for that when we are scoring the wharf, and that will happen twice during this game. Okay, then let's replenish accordingly. So we have the Caledonia and we have the Courier. Level 3 building. This would have been a very nice starting building, actually. But yeah, we also need a lot of resources for that, so maybe not so much. And then, yeah, it's basically back to our turn. I will move the saw down to the last wharf, but again, it's our turn. And actually, I think I already may have messed things up from a strategy perspective, because there would have been a way, I believe, to have tied with the sole proprietor here on the last stock, which would give us an additional 7 points. So instead of placing this ship here, we should have placed it here, and then we could have placed another ship in here. Yes, it would cost a lot of money, actually. Maybe that's the problem, but then we would have been able to tie at least. At least there would have been a chance. Right now, I don't think that that's going to happen. So we can place ship here without problems. That's okay. But we know we would at least place a ship here with another structure or even a building in this case. The sole proprietor would win there anyway. But maybe the 7 points are not that big of a deal at this point in time. Maybe there is something better we can do. So again, looking at our cards here, we could go for the ship or only the ship. We cannot build a building or construct a building. First, we could still scrap a building. And again, scrapping this building here would give us 3 structures, which is not bad to build something. On the other hand, building the noble here would give us more income for the next round to come. And again, money can be tight. And I'm right now tempted to do a little bit more of a prepping turn. And we could save some dollars here because we will not be able to score any more wharves anyway. For the next action, we might really want to consider scrapping this building here. So yeah, let's do that. Let's go for the noble. And again, don't take any of my playing decisions here very seriously. I have no clue what I'm doing here. So the noble is a level 3 ship. And I think I want to continue advancing on our board. In theory, we could place this building here, prepping for the next round, but I don't think that's $3 we would have to pay. So 1, 2, 3, placing it adjacent to 3, though that's not our best bet. And again, we are winning down here already, so that's also not the problem. So maybe we won't do something like this here, because again, this doesn't cost us anything. Yeah, let's do that. We get 1 free structure as we place it next to an opposing player's structure on the same level. That's important. It's really important. So if that would have been already on the second level, we wouldn't gain anything for that. But because it's the same level, it's a different player, we get this 1 step on the council track here accordingly. Slowly but steadily, we are making it somewhere. And again, if we are making it to this space here, we could go for another paper, and each paper is worth 2 points at the end of the game to us. So definitely something worth considering. Of course, we have to park our ship into our harbor, so we basically put the overlay. So in theory, everything here doesn't really matter at this point in time. For the buildings, yes, if there is something giving you some victory points, and yes, you should remember. With the expansion, there are also some unsinkable tokens which you shouldn't cover up, but in this case it's very easy. So we're getting 1 more wood out of this, and we will also gain 1 more income at the end of this round. So we're already at 2, and we really desperately need that. And we have to choose another card, and this is a tricky one. This is now where you really have to look at what the AI might be doing. First of all, I was thinking about getting the Caledonia. I want more ships. I only have buildings in my hands, so maybe having another ship is never a bad thing. But if I would go for the Caledonia, then I know the proprietor would go for the Courier. That's a size 3 building, which would mean I would have to extend the structures. If I would go for the Elmira, though, I know he will go for the size 2 building, which he could place at the current half without spending any more structures. And just this $1 more might be worth it. So I guess I'm going to do that. So I'm spending $2 here to grab myself the Elmira. Yeah, and then I have to check what I'm actually going to discard or basically put onto the display for the next round. So right now, again, I could make a case to trash or scrap the Elmira with my next action, because this would give me 3 victory points right off the bat. By I could extend my wharf, and that could be pretty huge actually. But I was also thinking about placing more structures out. I think that's also key for the next round. And this one is also great for the structures because it would also make the next card free. And I think that might be our case. So I think I want to hold on to those and will place the Bayview Couriers corner store into my display. And while I see the symbols here, there was a discussion. We had this card at our multiplayer session here and we weren't entirely sure how to score this one. I think that's what we ended up with in the end, was to say at the end of the game, you will have to make a call if you want to score paper, brick or steel. And for every one you have, you would then score 2 points. Whereas the player who got it started to debate, no, it's all of those. But then it was too cheap to build in the end. So in the end, we said, okay, no, we will go with this ruling here. If you happen to know that one, please let us know. But for now, I will put it into my next round selection. And then I know that the sole proprietor will go for the monument. Again, it's a level 2 building and the sole proprietor will always build this way to place the fewest additional structures as possible. As this is a level 2 or a size 2 building, it doesn't need to place any of those. So that's, I think, a good thing. So we will only go with one additional structure here. It's still a 2 on this wharf, but something we could start working on towards the end of, at least the end of the game. Again, for this particular round, when we will score those wharfs, I don't think we will have a chance making it, even though we still have 2 more action. That is maybe let's think about that. But again, this card is gone. We are moving this fella back up to the first wharf here, and I think there I couldn't care less. I would right now consider this to be a lost cause. Actually, I think our target should be those 2. I'm pretty sure we will not be able to score them, or even though there is an optional achievement, I believe, where you have to win the majority on all 3 wharfs in round 3. That is definitely a challenging one. Okay, let's reveal the Pembroke. That's an unsinkable ship, by the way, so we can never sink it. And we have the apartments. Quite inexpensive, actually, only a size 2, and would also give us an income of 1. That's something really worth considering. And it's our turn anyway. And again, the idea was to scrap something, right? Yes, we could build more ships, but I'm not sure if that's our best deal, because again, I'm looking at the theater here, which would give us the next building for free. But is there a building, or not building, the next card I'm playing, is there a card which we desperately want to have? I mean, yeah, the Elizabeth, that's a huge ship, actually, which could help me. That's no interest, but I really want those structures. I mean, that's the key part. Yeah, let's scrap this theater. So it's pretty much, I think, out of the game. It doesn't go to the discard pile, if I remember that correctly. And yeah, no, you will put it onto the appropriate discard pile, so it's still available for a later round. I don't think that this will happen in a 2-player game here, which we are kind of playing, but even in the 4-player game we played, we didn't fully went through the deck. We came close, but never had to reshuffle, actually. Okay, so we will get 3 structures, which we can build anywhere. And the problem now really is I will not be able to place them adjacent to an opponent. And that's really a bummer. But I think there were really no possibilities to achieve that in the first place. Again, that's really something that doesn't happen too often at the start of the game, but I'm pretty sure even in this kind of 2-player game, it should happen more often later on. So yeah, let's go with 3 of our structures. The question now is, I think I want to do, I mean, I could place 1 more here. Let's do this. Let's place 1 more here to secure the majority. So now we have 5 closer to this wharf here. Think this will help us. Then we will place 2 more in here. So this could be another level 4 building or size 4 building. I think that's also not the worst thing in the world. And again, we will get our card now for free. So I guess we are not immediately going for the apartments right now. Do we want to go with the Elizabeth? I mean, that's the most expensive card out there. And if we are scrapping that, we could sink a ship, just to score one of those landmark cards. Right now there aren't any landmark cards, but I think that's a pretty cool card. The Caledonia though is also not terrible because it gives us an additional income and some more wood. And we could, I mean, it's at least a dollar. I mean, a dollar is better than nothing. But what would, then we would go with a courier. He would build a level 3 building. And again, I couldn't care less, actually. He, level 6 building, that's a tough one. But then it's out, actually. Oh, I think if we would go for this, he wouldn't be able to build this one here legally. And there was a rule, if I remember that correctly. And yes, if there is no location where it's possible to construct the proper size building, construct as large of a building as possible, but treat it as a signature building and place a structure on every space of the newly placed building tile. That's really not bad. Because again, a building is only this cardboard piece, never the structure. So if we would go for the 6th building, he would have to place 2 structures in here and would build it completely. And then we would also, no, we would not gain anything, of course. Yes, he would place a building on top of it, actually, or a structure. And then we could also place a structure next to that. I think I may have talked more, I think, but that's true for all of those right now. Let's do that. Again, this might be a little bit short-sighted, but I will go for the Elizabeth for free. That's cool. So we saved ourselves $3 there. I have to park a card. We'll do that in a second. Or should we do it right now? Let's do it right now. And I guess there is no reason to place the Elizabeth on there, because right now, this the best bet would be to scrap a card to score that landmark building. Those can be pretty huge, actually. They all very relatively often require you to have a lot of these resources, which we don't have just yet. So yeah, let's deal with the armory for the sole proprietor. So again, it's this wharf here, and the prioritization says construct as close to the shore as possible, use existing structures as possible, as few structures as possible before building. And I think there are some more rules in there. Basically, it has to go to the lowest level. I guess that's the case. Again, this is one of the edge cases which I'm not sure. So would he now place it onto here? Or would we place it on here? The rules really say if there is more than one valid location, choose the location using these priorities, views, additional structures needed, lowest level. Yeah, of course, we cannot build a building on top of this. Of course, we could place 2 structures here, 2 structures there. That's the same amount of structures, but then we go for the lowest level. I think that's accurate. And I really hope that's typically where I'm not so good at following these kind of workflow ish things, but I believe that's the case. Again, it would have been a level 6 building, but that's all. I can't place that illegal, but we will treat it now as a signature building, which allows them to place basically 2 or a structure on each of the newly achieved nodes. And that's actually pretty good for us, because we now have 2 adjacent. So if we are placing a building here, we might be able later on to place them adjacent to that. Again, advancing on the city council. I think we played that correctly and hopefully also somewhat clever. We will discard the armory. Of course, let's not forget to move the saw down here. So we are dealing with our quote-unquote wharf here currently, and we have the majority with 5 versus 2 structures. So we really better try to keep that majority. We also don't want to lose those 7 points here either. So let's bring out some more cards. The garnet and another building, the supply yard. And I think whatever happens, we may want to go with the apartments, actually. They don't serve us anything right now, but I still think they're pretty cool to have. Could give us one more. And yeah, because they will be a level 2 building, actually, then we would score 4 points plus the 1 point here. So I think that's kind of a no-brainer, actually. But next we have to make a call what we are going to do with our last card here. We can scrap it. Again, that's pretty much translates into 3 points. On the other hand, we could create infill tiles with those, which would give us actually 2. No, we have to advance our, but that's okay. We could also gain 1 more step on the city council track, which is also not bad. So, and we could go for a mixture of both. On the other hand, we could also always still place that ship and we'll also get a step on the council track. And we need ships out there later on. And the question now is, should we start looking for points from the wolves or not? And again, if we build that ship, yeah, it doesn't give us any income. If that would have been an income ship, I think I would have build the ship, but now scrapping it sounds amazing. We can still build buildings now. Yeah, let's scrap it. So we get three of those infill or slash wharf tiles here. They're double-sided, by the way. Infill tiles, when you place them, you immediately get to place a structure next to them. The thing is, you have to place them adjacent to existing ships of yours. I think it's ships or structures. I think it's ships, or you have to extend your existing infill tiles. And the cool thing again, they come with structures, whereas wharf tiles can give you more points and also give you a dollar when you are placing those. Also something worth considering. So I guess I want to at least extend my wharf by one, right? So this gives me a dollar right away because I basically helped to build the infrastructure here in San Francisco, though that's a dollar. I take that. And I still have two more, and I could do that two more times. That's two more dollars and would give me also two more victory points, or maybe even four if I would be able to score that wharf twice. On the other hand, I could simply place some more infill tiles later on. So, for example, what I could do is place an infill tile here and there. This would cost me $2 though, because I'm still placing it adjacent to a wharf. And I also want some more steps, so maybe that's not our best bet right now. So I think our best bet would be to place an infill tile here, so it's adjacent to one of my ships. And we are placing one here. This costs me a dollar because it's adjacent to a wharf. So maybe I will be able to do something there. But I'm more concerned about these tiles. So one goes in here. That doesn't give us anything, unfortunately. And one goes in here. This is now adjacent to the same level of an opponent. So we are moving in here. So we get to choose. And I will definitely go for a paper because I have something that could score me some points at the end of the game if I will be able to hold on to that. And we are one step away from a landmark card, which could be cool for the Elizabeth later on. We will, in a solo game, we will draw two of those which are then available, simulating more players in this case. And yeah, I guess that's the end of our turn and also the round, actually. Of course, we still have to buy a card, and I guess this time we can play it strategically correct. I will go for the apartment, which means the sole proprietor will go for the Pembroke, which will score us some points. Yeah, I think we have to start gaming the game here. The apartments are free of charge because it was basically we already have placed five cards into our hand. This needs to go directly to our next round thing for $0, so that's okay. We have ended our round. We know that the sole proprietor will go for the Pembroke, which is a level 3 ship, and he totally ignores all those instructions, victory points, costs, and whatnot. We are simply building the ship now, or docking the ship, and I still believe that this works totally in our favor. Again, they will always place the ship adjacent to the wharf and basically extending the wharf. And whenever he's pretty much going beyond the current wharf, they will extend the wharf accordingly. So that's two more points for us. Oh, that's amazing, actually. That's really amazing. And of course, we are still placing one of the structures in here. Yeah. So he's already at four. No, three actually, and we are at five. So I think we should be okay in this case. We are not refilling the display. Yes, in theory, we should have to because everything gets wiped at the end of the round. And yeah, in theory, statistically, you should do that, but I'm not going to. And then we are doing end of round stuff. So I get my income. That's one here and one there. So that's $2 more. So I go into the next round with $9, which is okay, actually, or pretty good. But that's mainly true because I got one card for free. Again, all the cards in the current display are discarded. We are doing the scoring. And in a normal multiplayer game, we would now score a gold card. And those gold cards typically look like, so maybe I have one here. Yeah, actually, something like, whatever. This one here, total size of buildings, for example. So whoever has the most size of buildings out there gets 10 points, 6 points, 2 points, not counting structures, really the building size in this case. But in this case, we are not doing this in the solo game. We are only scoring the wharf in round one. In round two, we are scoring the city council track right now. Wouldn't give us anything, so we want to progress here. We already know that we will only win this wharf here. So again, we have 5 structures directly adjacent to that. The sole proprietor has 3, so we will score 7, 10 points in total. That's not bad. Here we only have 1, sole proprietor has 4, and here sole proprietor has 2, we don't have 0. But that's 10 points, which is not bad. So we are jumping from 8 up to 18 points, not too shabby. I will now bring out some more cards. So here we have the new ships and the new buildings, the Patriot, the Sacramento, the Potomac, and the Henry Lee here. That's another cool stuff. We have the Scribe, the boarding house, the repair shop, and the apartments. They're all realistic. I like those, actually. And then, yeah, last thing to do is to grab all of those cards. We put them into our hands. So that's what we have chosen. Though, again, it's totally on us, or rather me, what I'm ending up with. And I think one thing I forgot was to move the little saw down here to the next wharf. And then we are moving already into round two. But I think for today I will call it. And honestly, I have to say, so far I'm really do enjoy that, and I didn't think I would. I may have done some of the decisions here incorrectly for the iPlay. I still think that was okay, but I like the fact that yes, you don't have to look too much for a lot of opponents, but you really have to start controlling the one opponent you have, and that's part of your decision making, which ships or which building you are taking, or are you taking a ship or a building. And I really must say, I like what I'm seeing so far here with the solo modes. Definitely looking forward to rounds 2 and 3 of this game. Hope you do too. Again, huge shout out to all of my patrons and channel members out there. In fact, I do have a new patron on my channel, a very generous one. I'm not 100% sure if they are happy that I'm sharing the name, which I will not do at this point in time. I reached out but didn't hear, so not sure. Reach out to me. Let me know if you are fine. So again, do totally appreciate your support, even if you want to do it silently, that's totally fine. If you want to support my little channel, you will find something or a link to my page on Patreon. You can join me here directly on YouTube. Leave a like or subscribe, leave a comment, always helps and definitely appreciate it. And yeah, hope to see you soon in one of my other videos. And until then, bye bye.